thematically, I've always dealt with isolation in everything I've written, I think. Right. Is this smoke bothering you?
No, it's not at all. Good. It's going to make you that mysterious viewer that you've talked about.
I never wanted to appear as myself on stage, ever, at any time, until recently, I think. So as I did write in character form, I wanted to produce those characters on stage, which is something I feel I did quite successfully at the time. Well, I went to Los Angeles and I lived there for a couple of years, which is a city I really detest. I like the real cities, like Chicago and Detroit. Mm. Detroit has real people energetically trying to survive. But in Los Angeles, it's fabrication.
Transmitters to full, all receivers to boost. This is London calling. This is London calling.
And so now I'd like to say, people can change anything they want to. And that means everything in the world. People are running about following their little tracks. I am one of them. But we've all got to stop just following our own little mouse trail. People can do anything. This is something that I'm beginning to learn. People are out there doing bad things to each other. It's because they've been dehumanized. It's time to take the humanity back into the center of the ring and follow that for a time. Greed, it ain't going anywhere. They should have that in a big billboard across Times Square. Without people, you're nothing. That's my spiel.
Is he the only?
I might change my mind tomorrow, but if you ask me immediately, those are the first things that come to mind.
Yes. And as a child, who do you think influenced you?
Donald Duck.
Was he your favourite character then?
I loathed him. He made me learn how to hate.
You know, that's very odd. I've always hated Donald Duck. He sends me quite crackers when I hear him.
Very unlikable.
Did you dislike Mickey Mouse as much?
Yes.
Did you like any of the traditional people that you were supposed to like?
No.